China never opened its economy to the world, and now it is paying the price by being left at the mercy of the free world. In the last four decades, China developed its unique model of capitalism, popularly known as socialism with Chinese characteristics. In this model, China supported state-led capitalism under which it aggressively promoted foreign investment, manufacturing and exports in the country and benefited from globalization and free trade but kept its economy closed. The country imposed various regulations on foreign companies, especially those operating in the service sector, to ensure that the domestic market of more than a billion people gets exploited only by domestic companies. This model benefited the country immensely as China became a global leader in exports and a manufacturing hub for Western companies, while at the same time, the domestic companies faced no competition from foreign players given severe restrictions and regulations. Companies like Huawei, Tencent, Alibaba became giants and started exploring the foreign markets after they exploited the Chinese consumer base and got the confidence to operate out of the country. The Chinese government also supported foreign expeditions of these companies through cheap loans and diplomacy. The country has the ambition of global domination through companies like Huawei and Tencent. However, these ambitions have hit a stumbling block thanks to Donald Trump, who started the movement of reversing globalization and free trade. And after that came the coronavirus pandemic, which forced countries to look inwards. Now, countries around the world have started punishing China by throwing Chinese companies out of their markets and have put severe restrictions on Chinese investment and imports. But given the fact that China did not allow foreign companies in its market, it cannot reciprocate the same. If Indian companies have the same kind of interests in the Chinese market like the Chinese companies have in India, the Modi government would have hesitated in banning Chinese companies from Indian markets given the fear of reciprocal decisions from the Chinese government. But as Indian companies have little interest in China, the Modi government could punish Chinese companies in India without a second thought. The same is true for the other markets like the United States, with which China has a trade surplus of more than $400 billion. So when Trump threatens to punish Chinese companies, he does not fear that American companies in China would meet the same fate, because a very small number of American companies have large business interests in China. A few days ago, the head of the European Chamber of Commerce in China highlighted that Chinese companies have bought a port in Greece through which it manages its exports to the European Union, but the European companies cannot purchase a port in China to manage exports to South Korea. The same goes for law firms, he added. So China kept its economy closed and did not allow foreign firms to have significant interests in its own country. And therefore, it is now at the mercy of free economies like the United States, the European Union, and India. China's unfriendly business conditions were the main reason behind its unimpressive 96th rank in the World Bank's Doing Business list in 2014. But it seems that China was soon able to overwhelm the intergovernmental financial institution with its increasing shareholding and influence in the administration. As the voting power of China grew, the organization improved its ranking dramatically in the last few years, only to realize in 2020 that the communist government supplied false data. China has risen dramatically in the World Bank's ease of doing business rankings. Between 2016 and 2020, China's ease of doing business rankings improved from 84 to 31. More shockingly, China's rankings improved from 78 to 31 between 2018 and 2020, which is the same period that has now come under the scanner. The World Bank was singing paeans for China's strong reform agenda, while the Xi Jinping administration was fast making China an unpopular business destination. It is well known that it isn't easy to do business in China, especially for foreign firms. State dominance in certain sectors, political interference, an extensive negative list of sectors in which foreign firms are restricted, and other restrictions make mainland China a not-so-popular business destination. But why did the World Bank not take these factors into account while ranking China? In a shock to the global community, the World Bank has confessed that its ease of doing business list is unreliable. Four countries, Azerbaijan, China, Saudi Arabia, and the United Arab Emirates, reportedly committed data irregularities in its 2018 and 2020 list. This latest revelation only adds up to World Bank's unchecked history of a strong bias towards China, including its generous lending for a country that itself happens to be a giant global creditor. It is evident that China never opened up its economy, but only fooled institutions like World Bank and the World Health Organization to improve its ranking in socio-economic indicators. But in a world ruled by leaders like Trump, Modi, and Shinzo Abe, Beijing could no longer fool the world. And it is at the mercy of the free world to save its economy.